Welcome to A View to a Grill. I'm Johnny, and today I'm going to show you how to maintain your target temperature on the Weber kettle using a slow and sear. Now, if you're wondering how to reach your target temperature on the Weber kettle, I actually shot a video of that, and you can check that out in the link above. Now, after going through all of the motions of reaching our target temperature, we will now attempt to maintain our target temperature of 275 degrees. 10 degrees above or 10 degrees below is okay with me. Now, once you've come within your target temperature range of plus or minus 10 degrees, it's important that you don't leave. This is a great time to have a beer. Stick around your pit and wait for adjustments to be needed. And here we are, 281 degrees. If we refer back to our chart, we're still doing good, but do a small micro adjustment. And when we're at 281 degrees, that is going to cause us to close the event just a little bit. We're going to wait 10 minutes for this adjustment to take effect. 10 minutes have gone by and we've actually gone up a degree. So now we're going to refer back to our chart and see that we are going to make another micro adjustment and we're going to close the vent down just a little bit again. And notice how I'm doing this adjustment. I'm just barely tapping that vent because I really do want this to be a micro adjustment. Now we're going to wait for 10 minutes. And now the temperature is in the great part of the range. And I'm not going anywhere. I'm going to hang around the pit. I'm going to look at Fred the squirrel. I'm going to stick by the pit so that I can make an adjustment if necessary. If you don't want to be around your pit, you can get yourself a barbecue guru. And I have those in the link below. Now let's check out the graph on the IBBQ4T. It actually felt comfortable leaving it in the high range of our temperature range because the line was getting pretty flat and it seemed like that's where the temperature wanted to be that day. So sometimes you don't mess with it, you just go with it. If the temperature is starting to flat line at the high part of your range, then that's okay. You may want to adjust your range. Because whatever reason, humidity, wind, rain, it's cold outside, it's hot outside, on that particular day, it seemed like the high part of our range was where our pit wanted to be. And then, as soon as you get comfortable, as things always happen, the unexpected happens. As you can see at 401, our temperature was at 282 degrees. And for whatever reason, by 408, we dropped to 264 degrees. That is a full 18 degrees in 6 minutes. And that's why when you're smoking, you need to be available to react to these types of temperature swings. Let's refer to our chart and we see that this is a case for a micro open. You still want to stick with the micro opens and micro closes, even though that temperature fell fast. So you refer to your chart and stick to your game plan and then just barely tap that vent open. And 10 minutes later, the temperature is going back up. But since we waited 10 minutes and it's still below that great part of the range, we're going to go ahead and do another micro open. Now, 10 minutes later, we're at 269. Now, normally it does call for another micro open here, but the temperature is rising fast enough to where I'm going to give it another 5 minutes. And without having to adjust the vent again, we're right around that perfect range. Now, whenever you take the lid off, your temperature is going to plummet, but you can't panic. So let's take the lid off and talk about temperature recovery. As you can tell by our graph, we took the lid off and our temperature fell. We'll take this time to ooh and ah at the ham because it's looking fantastic and we'll put the lid back on. This is where the vents were when we took the lid off. And the first thing we're going to do is nothing. We're going to leave those vents right where they are. We are not doing a darn thing. And as you can see, with the lid back on, our temperature is going back up. And watching this, this is where I don't want you to panic. When we took the lid off, we flooded that chamber with fresh, brand new oxygen. And the fire is going to love it. So looking at my graph, you're going to see that we're actually going to overshoot our target temperature and go well beyond the bad range. And once that happens, the first thing you need to do is nothing. Don't do anything. Because we need to let the environment and the Weber kettle readjust. We need the fire to burn off some of that brand new oxygen we just put in there. So don't do anything. It's going to be hard, I know, but don't do anything. And then watching our graph, we finally see that curve start to flatten. Now the curve is going downward and we're back in our target range. And we never once adjusted any vents. So as far as this Weber kettle is concerned, temperature recovery is all about you keeping your hand off the vent. The Weber kettle usually almost always recovers by itself. So keep your hand off that vent. As you can see by our graph, we've been in our target temperature range for a while now. We'll take another look at our ham. And if you've made it this far, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Thank you for watching a View 2 Grill, and I'll see you next time.